In this video, I will show you the techniques I apply when working with GitHub Copilot. I will spend most of this demonstration in the Copilot chat in VS Code. You can start from this page if you wish to try it yourself. Make sure to explore the pricing. There are a limited number of free requests, which should be enough for you to try it out. I'm using this plan, which is $10 a month. You can also find a list of IDEs with GitHub Copilot support, including VS Code, Visual Studio, and JetBrains IDEs. Let's get to the application, where I want to show you some tips and tricks for the effective use of Copilot. This is the bear.net web application just created from the template. I will pretend there is a request for a change in a domain where I don't feel too confident. The request is to improve the UI by implementing a dark theme. The first naive attempt could be just to tell Copilot to turn the CSS into a dark theme. What shall it do with this request? Oh, and don't forget to be kind to the machines. You never know. Let's see the response. It says the code I provided is a C# file, not a CSS file. What does that mean? When you use Copilot chat in VS Code, it automatically selects the active editor as the context. Copilot always responds within the current context. You can switch this feature off in the settings if you want, but it is beneficial to let Copilot include the active document in the context. The Copilot was looking at program.cs and it said, "Oh, this is a C# file, I can't do that." What worries me is that it went further by actually writing some CSS content. This CSS just won't work, and I can tell that at first glance. Many would call that a hallucination. You can use the /clear command in the chat to start a new session. I want to try again. An important lesson for you is to first navigate to the file you plan to change, which would be the CSS file in this example. But even with the changed context, I still cannot just tell it, "Turn this CSS into a dark theme, please." Nobody speaks like that to a machine. Here's the problem. Copilot would indeed respond with a modified CSS. If you read that CSS, it's quite different from what we had before. It does make sense at first glance. Copilot even went so far as to explain what it changed in the CSS. Now let's see the results. There is a button that says Apply to File. When you click that, the Copilot will walk through the file content and apply the changes diligently. It displays the old and new content so that you can choose whether to keep its changes or undo them. I will keep these changes and save them so that I can see what happens with my application. I'm refreshing the page now and you can see it doesn't really look right. This navigation bar at the top is still white. Back to the drawing table. I'm not managing this very well, but I will continue in the same direction so you can see why this method of interacting with Copilot is a bad idea. I just say the menu bar in the HTML page is still white. Please change the CSS to make that dark too. It gives me some explanation and offers a modification. Copilot will go to great lengths to merge its new ideas into the old file. So I accept these changes, hoping they will solve the problem with the menu bar. Let's see. When I refresh, it goes from bad to worse. No, that is definitely not what I need. Back to square one. I will clear this session and start all over again. Enough playing around. It is time for you to start learning how to talk to GitHub Copilot. I have tried this approach with a few other large language models, and they reacted similarly. The first mistake I want to correct is the informal speaking style. I said please in every sentence, but that's not enough to make Copilot work well. It requires detailed information. So the first lesson is, be specific. Let's try being specific. Modify the CSS to satisfy these requirements, and then list the requirements. All elements on the page are in a dark theme. The menu bar is also a dark theme. Mention the specific items on which you saw it fail the first time. But the story doesn't end here. Then comes the step that prevents hallucinations. list what you want the Copilot to verify. The menu bar is in a dark theme. You want Copilot to check that the new change will work. Then instead of saying please, I have a better idea. Give Copilot an option to fail gracefully instead of hallucinating. The problem I created before was that I asked Copilot to change the CSS, but I did not supply enough information on how to do that accurately, so it made up the missing information and produced random content. We call that a hallucination, but it is a perfectly regular and even expected response from an LLM. How do we prevent hallucinations? We let Copilot know it can also avoid responding if it cannot verify the changes. So I'm allowing Copilot not to respond to my request. Look what it does. It says, I'm sorry, I can't verify the changes to ensure the menu bar is in a dark theme. That is great news. I like it much better when the model says it can't produce what I asked for than producing incorrect code. This failure teaches us the virtue of writing specific requirements. Attempt number 3 begins here. I'm almost ready to succeed. I have realized I was wrong from the beginning. It's not the CSS I want to change. I want to change how this page looks instead. The CSS is just a consequence. So let's give Copilot a more specific task. Make changes so that this page is displayed using the dark theme and ensure that the menu bar is also displayed in a dark theme. Before producing any modifications, verify that all elements, including the menu bar, will be in the dark theme. If you cannot verify the changes, do not change any files. When I press Enter, the message repeats. Sorry, I can't verify the elements including the menu bar will be in the dark theme. Therefore, I cannot make any modifications to the files. Very good. I'm clearing the session and starting the fourth attempt, but now I see the solution. But before I show you the most powerful technique and the only one that will truly work, let me remind you that you can support my channel on Patreon. Every patron is helping hundreds of other fellow programmers watch more than 100 videos on my channel for free. You can follow the link from the description and look at the goodies you can get as a patron. Now, let's end this work. Begin by formulating the proper request. The request is to display the page using the dark theme. All elements must be displayed in a dark theme, including the menu bar. That is an absolute requirement. Now comes the question for Copilot. List the files that require changes to implement this request. Before outputting any files, verify that these files affect the look of index when rendered. If you cannot verify, do not list any files. A control freak in me wants to make this sound even stronger, but I don't think it will make a difference. This time we see a well-structured response. It tells me that besides index, there is also site.css, the layout and two shared files, view imports and view start. If you are an ASP.NET Core developer, you will know these are indeed the files you need to check if you want to change the style of the index page. Now we're talking. Then I return to the question of context. I must include these files in the context before asking Copilot to change them. You can do that in the chat using a hash file directive. Just press Enter and pick the file to include, such as site.css or layout.cshtml. By the way, there is an experimental feature in GitHub Copilot that you can switch on. It is called Copilot Code Search. It is still in preview, but you can enable it to allow Copilot to read your entire codebase. Instead of listing individual files, you can use hash codebase. I will not dive any deeper into that in this demo, but I encourage you to try it on your own. In this video, I wanted to show you the bare bones operation of Copilot. So I'm manually adding the remaining files to the context. I want you to understand that Copilot always answers within the context of the active file, the files you explicitly added, plus the entire conversation above in this chat. Now, with all these elements in place, you ask the question. Make all necessary changes to implement the dark theme request. Before changing any files, verify that the change will produce a dark theme look, including the look of the menu bar. If you cannot verify the changes, do not change any files. Those last two items should prevent hallucinations. The response looks reasonable at first glance. It shows changes to the CSS file and the layout view. The style sheet changes indeed look like a dark theme this time. The layout is more important because that didn't work the first time. This time it mentions a dark style for the navigation bar and a light style for the text. Let's apply changes to both files and see what happens. The light colors are replaced with the dark ones for the navigation bar, and the default text color is replaced with a lighter color. I'm accepting all the changes. I reverted the previous change so it is the default theme again. When I refresh, it appears in dark mode with a dark menu bar. But some text is not readable. We are making progress, though the result is not perfect. However, it is a good foundation for what I need. I could end the video at this point because you already have a pretty good understanding of what to do. Just add the relevant files to the context, then request what you need. I am requesting that all the text in the menu bar be in a light color. Request the verification. Tell Copilot not to make any changes if it cannot verify them. Copilot suggests enforcing the light color in the menu bar with the important CSS rule. I do not like the idea at first glance, but I apply it, refresh the page, and it gives the result. There are more glitches on this page. Some text in the footer is dark on a dark background. I will not fix that here because I think you have grasped the point. The lesson is that if you want Copilot to work for you, you need to work with Copilot. Bring the right context in, give specific requests, ask it to verify the output before producing it. Ultimately, give it a way out if it cannot answer based on the information it possesses. What you see here is one long session with Copilot developed in the style I just outlined. If you can replicate this process in your own work, you will probably notice that Copilot responds with reasonable and useful changes to your code.